Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. So in this video, I am going to explain you how you can write binary search algorithm, and this algorithm will be applied on 1D array, right? So first understand how binary search algorithm works. So let's say I have this 1D array. Total 10 blocks are available here. So whenever you want to apply binary search on any array, so you need to remember that your array should be in sorted order. So the conclusion is you can apply binary search only on sorted arrays. If your array is not sorted, so first you need to sort all the elements rather in ascending or descending order. Then only you can apply binary search on that array. So we are assuming that our array is already sorted and it has these 10 elements, right? Now let's say I need to search an element that is 18. So these are the positions of the array elements. So in algorithm, I already told you in my previous videos that first position is denoted as 1 and last position is denoted as n. So here, this first position index is 1, last position index is 10. So in case of binary search, first you need to identify the mid position. So mid we identify by adding lower bound and upper bound and divided by 2. So here 1 plus 10 equals to 11 by 2, so it will be 5.5, and we consider it as 5. So this fifth position will be mid position. So now we need to compare this item that we want to search whether it is equal to the mid position value. So if it is equal to that position, then it means number is found. If it is not equal, then the number that we are going to search will be less than with this value, or it will be greater than with this value. So that's why we need sorted array, right? So 18 will be compared with 15. So 18 is greater than 15. It means next we are going to search the element into this part of array, not in this part. And if the number you want to search is less than 15, then we need to search the element in this part of array, not in right inside part of array. And further, if we take this one, so this will be your lower bound, this will be your upper bound. Again, you need to calculate the mid, and if your element is available on the mid position, then number is found. Otherwise, check it on left hand side of that array or right hand side. So this way we divide 1D array into two parts based on the mid position, and either on left part or right part we further search that element whether it is available or not. So this is the basic idea of binary search algorithm. Now I am going to write that algorithm so that you can understand how we can implement the steps of binary search. So name of algorithm is binary search. Now I am going to write the variables that will be required for this algorithm. So these are the variables that will be required. So here A is sorted array that we have used. LB is lower bound, that will be 1. UB is the upper bound, that will be 10. Then item that we are going to search, and LOC will be having the location where that element is available, right? So now I am going to write step number 1. So in case of step number 1, we need to set beginning equals to lower bound, right? So beginning will be equals to lower bound and end will be equals to upper bound. So these variables values are initialized into beginning and end variable, right? And in step number 2, I am going to calculate mid position value. So we will be calculating mid to beginning plus end divided by 2. So with this formula, mid position index will be identified. Now after this, so here also I get the same. I have identified lower bound and upper bound, and through adding lower bound with upper bound divided by 2, I identified this mid position. So same thing I wrote here, right? Now repeat steps. So here I am going to apply a loop. So let me create these things. So I am going to repeat step number 4 and 5, right? So steps number 4 and 5 will be repeated. Why? Beginning is less than equals to end. Why? Beginning is less than equals to end. End A of mid position value is not equals to item. So this is the item that we are going to search. If it is not equal to A of mid position value and beginning is less than equals to end, so if both the conditions are true, then the steps number 4 and 5 will be repeated. Otherwise, this loop will be terminated. Now, I have to write step number 4. So here I am going to check if item is less than A of mid. If item is less than A of mid, so let's suppose mid position is having 15 and item is less than mid. So in that case, we need to search the element in this array. So here lower bound is already set, that is one. We need to change the upper bound value. So here you need to write set n equals to mid minus 1. So mid is positioning on fifth position. So mid minus 1 will be 4. So that will be assigned into n. So beginning will be pointing to this position and end is positioning to this position, right? And if this condition is false, it means item is greater than A of mid. Item is greater than A of mid. So in that case, beginning should be there and end should be here. So end is already on this position. So we need to change the beginning position. So else set beginning equals to mid plus 1, right? Then after setting these values, you need to calculate mid position again, because we are working on this array or we are working on this part of array. So again, we need to identify the mid position. So after this, you need to write set mid equals to beginning plus end divided by 2. So inside this loop, again, mid position will be calculated and this will be checked here. So beginning is less than equals to end and A of mid is not equals to item. So again, these steps will be calculated. So after completion of this algorithm, again, I will take this example and step by step we will follow like how it will be working. Now here I can write end of loop. So after completion of this loop, I need to write step number 6. So in case of step number 6, I need to check mid position with item. So if A of mid equals to item, then set LOC equals to. So here you need to assign the value of mid to LOC. So whenever A of mid will be equals to item, it means item is available on this mid position. So LOC will be assigned as mid. Otherwise, set LOC equals to null or zero or whatever you want to assign. And then step number 7 will be end of this algorithm. So this way, this algorithm is implemented. So now we are going to take this example so that you can understand this properly. So lower bound, upper bound will be assigned to beginning or end. So let's say beginning is 1, end is 10. Then we need to calculate the mid position. So 11 by 2. So mid position will be 5. So this is our mid position, right? And the item that we are going to search is 18. So check this condition, beginning less than equals to end, so it is true. A of mid not equals to item, so A of mid is 15, that is not equals to item, that is 18. So both the conditions are true. Now check this condition, item is less than A of mid, so A of mid is 15, item is 18, so again it is false. So else will be executed, so beginning equals to mid plus 1, so mid is 5, so beginning will be 6. So you can see, we need to search the element in this part of array from 6 to 10. Then again we need to calculate the mid. So this time beginning plus end. So beginning is 6, end is 10. So total is 16. 16 by 2 is 8. So new mid position will be 8. Again check this condition, beginning less than equals to end. So it is 2. A of mid not equals to item. So A of mid is 8. So 8th position value is equals to item. So this is false now. So this loop will stop or terminate here and control will be transferred to this 6th step. So here you need to check if A of mid equals to item. So it is true. So mid position value will be assigned to LOC. So LOC will be having value as 8. It means on 8th position that number is available and this algorithm will be terminated. So this way, with this process, you can check whether a particular number is available in 1D array or not. Remember one thing, whenever you want to apply binary search, your array should be arranged in sorted form. If it is not arranged in sorted form, then your results will be incorrect, because binary search algorithm prerequisite is sorted array. So I hope with this way you understood how we can implement binary search algorithm. If you want to watch how we can implement binary search algorithm with C language, so you can go to description of this video and you will find link of a playlist that is data structure using C. So go to that playlist and there you will find a video based on binary search algorithm implementation with C language. So watch that so that you can understand how we can write a program based on binary search algorithm. So I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video. So thank you for watching this video.